Get back to your evening. So my name's Brett Veinotte. I was a teacher, an educator for the better part of 10 years. About 6 years ago, I started a website called schoolsucksproject.com, which is kind of trying to make the distinction, especially for young people, between schooling and education. They're two very different things. And we're here tonight to hopefully raise some money for an author who, under very, very different circumstances and with a great number of challenges that I didn't have in the information age, set out on a similar mission to make that distinction. And his name's John Taylor Gatto. He was a New York State public school teacher for about 30 years, including the New York Teacher of the Year, I think in the early 90s. He quit, I want to say 1992, and he became a very outspoken critic of the public school system. In the last 5 years, and now, amazing body of work followed. He goes on speaking tours. He's very eloquent, very, very interesting man, and he really has this great message of, inspiring young people and old people with, messages of self-reliance and curiosity, and he's been such a huge influence on me. And I just wanted to talk very, very quickly about that influence. I was in graduate school, I think it was like 2003, and I was researching for some paper. I don't remember exactly what it was. I don't remember the search terms that I entered into Ask Jeeves, I guess it would have been. But I get Gatto's site. And I see the title of this book. I have it right here. Dumbing Us Down, it was called. I remember the name because I said, hey, that guy's name is Spanish for cat. But how could anyone, especially someone in graduate school who's working to become a teacher, and a high school principal, that was why I was there, forget a title like this, Dumbing Us Down, the Hidden Curriculum of Compulsory Schooling. And I don't know if it was more like it planted a seed, or it triggered a bomb, a time bomb that was going to go off much later, but all the negative experiences I had both in school and in the graduate program were always kind of reinforced by this subtle message that I picked up just from looking at his website for a matter of minutes. And I said, that's interesting. School is a conspiracy to make people dumb. That's silly. Back to work, I said. But then I looked out and a lot of people were dumb. Quite honestly. And it stuck with me. I encountered his work again in 2006, 2010. I found this book, which is like the Rosetta Stone of the history of the public school system, the people who shaped it, why they wanted it. And it was when I first encountered this, it was after I had started doing the show, that I guess it occurred to me, I know it's a cliche, but that I trying to do the School Sucks podcast and School Sucks project was really standing on the shoulders of giants. What John Taylor Gatto assembled by the year 2000 in this book, absolutely amazing. And I remember hearing him tell this story one time about doing research to try and find out about this guy. His name was James Bryant Conant. He was the president of Harvard for 22 years. And writing letters to people and waiting for responses. You know, when we have Google and Control Find and books like this to use for our research today, he assembled this amazing work with none of that. And for everybody who's interested in either providing real, authentic education to their kids or speaking out against the increasing list of horrors that we see in the public schools today, like medicating kids and zero tolerance, we owe this guy a lot. So there's actually a card over there that people can sign. And I want to thank Carl and Laura for organizing this event. And I'm guessing that, Carl, you'd be a good person to talk to if people are actually interested in the money part.
Yes, please.
All right, so without further ado, a super talented musician, my friend, Carlos Perez.
Thank you. So, while I was playing, one of my strings ran completely out of tune, so in order to draw your attention, instead of playing something else.
Alright, so,
play something else.
Yeah.
Nobody can get it. You know this room, you guys.
know your name.
Thank you.
right. I'm going to try something I haven't tried before. It should be fun.
This thing still going? We still recording?